How do organisms reproduce? In this lecture, we will be learning about the reproduction methods in different living things. Introduction. The reason why we are living today is because of reproduction. Reproduction is an essential process for the propagation of various life forms. For a much clearer understanding, we first need to know what actually reproduction means. So, coming to reproduction, it is a biological process by which new individuals of the same parental kind are produced. For example, plants reproduce to give a new plant. Dogs reproduce to give a new baby dog or puppy. But in some cases, like humans or any other animal, the reproduced product is not 100% alike to its parents. There is some variation getting introduced. These variations are maybe due to environment of development of the baby organism and also due to variation in the genetic material. Now let's learn something more on variation. So coming to variation, the differences found among individuals of a group or species caused either by genetic differences or by effect of environment or genes is known as variation. An important note: reproduction is not essential for the survival of an organism, but it is vital for the survival of a species. Reproduction produces identical copies of the body design. A role of DNA in reproduction. DNA is the informational micromolecule of our body. It provides information for protein synthesis. During cell reproduction, DNA duplication occurs, followed by creation of an additional cellular apparatus. The process of DNA copying is not accurate, resulting in the variation arising due to reproduction, which is the basis for evolution. Reproduction in single organisms. Actually, reproduction can be done in two ways. They are asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Single organisms reproduce by asexual methods of reproduction. Asexual methods of reproduction. They are fission, fragmentation, budding, vegetative propagation, and spore generation. Now let's start with fission. A type of asexual reproduction in which unicellular parent organism divides into two or more parts, each developing into a genetically identical individual. Given below are the types of fission. Please have a look. Binary fission is the one in which two daughter cells are similar. Multiple fission is the type of fission in which two or more than two similar daughter cells are formed. An example of fission has been shown below. Binary fission is usually found in amoeba, whereas multiple fission is found in plasmodium. Fragmentation. The reproductive method in which certain multicellular organisms on maturation break up into smaller fragments, each of which develops into a new individual. Budding. the reproductive method in which an organism produces an outgrowth on its body surface, which then matures and develops into a new individual. Budding process is more predominant in plants like Hydra. Vegetative propagation. The reproductive method in which new plants are produced asexually from roots, stems, or leaves of the parent plant. Spore generation. A small, usually single-celled reproductive body produced by certain fungi, bacteria, etc., which is highly resistant to desiccation and heat and is capable of growing into a new organism. Given below is a diagram of a spore generation. Now, let's learn about sexual reproduction. A mode of reproduction in which new individuals are produced by fusion of a male and a female gamete. Sexual reproduction requires both male and female sexes to produce the offspring. Sexual reproduction creates a large number of variations. Sexual reproduction and flowers. This is how the flower looks. Stamen is the male reproductive part of the flower, which is made up of the anther and the filament. Carpel is the female reproductive part and is composed of stigma, style, and ovary. Flowers reproduce by a sexual method called as pollination. Pollination is nothing but the transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma. The pollen grain is present in the anther, whereas the egg cell is enclosed in the ovary. The pollination can happen in two ways: self-pollination and cross-pollination. Self-pollination is a transfer of pollen grains by natural processes such as wind or insects. Cross-pollination is a transfer of pollen grains through a manual method between two different flowers. When the pollination occurs, the pollen grains start germinating as shown below. After the pollen lands on a suitable stigma, it has to reach the female germ cell, which is in the ovary. After fertilization, the zygote divides several times to form an embryo within the ovule. The ovule develops a tough coat and is gradually converted into a seed. The ovary grows rapidly and ripens to form a fruit. Reproduction in human beings. In humans, reproduction occurs sexually. Puberty is the time when the juvenile body of a person starts sexual maturation. Before puberty, the body resources are used mainly to grow and develop the organisms to its adult size. Once this is achieved, puberty sets in. Some changes occurring during puberty are common to boys and girls, whereas the other changes are specific to boys and girls. Changes such as appearance of pimples on face, growth of thick hair in armpits and genital areas occur both in boys and girls. Increase in the breast size, darkening of the nipples and occurrence of the menstruation are puberty associated changes in girls. In boys, facial hair growth, cracking of voice and occasional enlargement of penis occurs during puberty. Changes associated with puberty are slow and gradual and does not occur uniformly in everyone. The changes taking place during puberty signal the occurrence of sexual maturation in an individual to other members of the same population. Now, let's learn about the male and the female reproductive systems. Starting with the male reproductive system. In humans, the male reproductive system is composed of the testes, vas deferens, seminal viscus, prostate glands, urethra, and the penis. Testes is situated outside the abdominal cavity. It produces sperms and secretes testosterone. Vas deferens and urethra are thin tubes through which sperms are transported to the penis. Sperms show a small head containing genetic material and a long tail. Sperms are nourished in the seminal fluid. Female reproductive system. The female reproductive system is made of ovaries, fallopian tubes, uterus, cervix, and the vagina. Given below is a sketch. Ovaries are responsible for the production of ova, egg, as well as for secreting of the hormones oestrogen and progesterone. On reaching puberty, ovulation occurs once a month in females, wherein one immature egg present in any one of the ovaries becomes mature and is released. The egg is carried by the fallopian tube. Usually, while having sex, sperms which are introduced into the vagina of the female during the intercourse may encounter the egg on reaching the fallopian tube, resulting in fertilization. The zygote gets implanted in the uterus and develops into the embryo. The placenta provides nourishment and oxygen to the embryo and removes the waste generated by the embryo. Gestation period is 9 months in humans, after which the child is born due to uterine contractions. What if the fertilization doesn't happen? In case the fertilization doesn't happen, the released egg along with the thickened lining of the uterus is shed out through the vagina in a process called menstruation. Few tips on reproductive health. Engaging in unprotective sexual intercourse can cause pregnancy as well as spreading of sexually transmitted diseases like AIDS. Condoms help to control the spread of sexually transmitted diseases. Unwanted pregnancies can be avoided through several contraceptive methods. Mechanical barrier methods prevent sperm from reaching the egg. For example, condom. Oral contraceptive pills alter the hormonal balance, thereby preventing the egg from being released. Surgical blocking of vas deferens in males or fallopian tubes in females can also prevent pregnancy. Abortions remove unwanted pregnancies, but this is a method which has been misused for female feticide. Birth control methods are essential to keep the human population in check and thereby improving the standard of living for everyone. The end. Thank you for watching.